Uroloki versus P2P with Gibbous.
Dude, Uroloki looks like... He looks so upset right now.
Like,
I was like, man.
Somebody give me a challenge. Because he just ran through Denti and slaps in the losers. Denti and then slaps. The winner of last week's Shockwave. Slaps. Hello?
Crazy. Uroloki is definitely looking to win this game or win this tournament today. And against Gibbous, who is not shy of winning tournaments himself, this is going to be a definite test of his mettle tonight.
Mm-hmm. Going to be the Greninja using all that speed that he needs. Definitely not going to go Lucario in this matchup.
Oh yeah, it's way too scary. With the kill potential that Cloud has, you do not want to chance it on what Aura can bring.
And the juggles too.
Oh, crazy. Missing that grab. Wow, that would have been a lot for him. Now Uroloki's coming on the attack, getting so much damage. That trade definitely was in his favor because now he has limit. Now he can take out the stock. What a neutral air.
He's got the stage control. He's forced Gibbous into the corner, but Gibbous smartly rolls out. He knows Uroloki's looking for that neutral getup, and Gibbous gave it to him. Only to escape the situation and punish with a forward smash.
Oh, but he's been so on point. He's landed so many up smashes tonight, trying to fish for yet another. That roll read was the hardest of roll reads I've seen all night. But Uroloki has been connecting his sword so often to Gibbous' face. Gibbous needs to be a bit more careful with how he approaches and when he gets into those ranges, but that sword's going to start tearing him apart as it has been.
Ooh, definitely trying to expect.
Oh my gosh, what a punish! What a punish! He knew Gibbous was going to go for yet another down air, and he was able to punish accordingly with that up air. Two fantastic trades for Uroloki in this set so far.
Right now he's got 90% on him, but he can definitely rack up the damage on Gibbous. That said, Gibbous probably has, especially with the weight of Cloud, might be able to confirm up throw up air or down throw forward air. At this percent, Uroloki cannot get complacent.
Yeah, he needs to be very careful. He can't allow himself to get grabbed and put into these 50-50 situations that Gibbous can put him in. But he's also getting so much damage currently, 36% onto Gibbous, and he's not afraid to contest whatever option Gibbous throws out.
Oh my gosh.
And not getting punished? What?
That is insane how he got away with that. Not only did he go for it, but he got away with it.
All right. Gibbous still trying to find a way to put out the stock. He is throwing out far too many down airs for my comfort. Whoa. I thought he was going to utilize that stage moving or platform moving to do something with it. But still, he's unable to get this stock. The up throw, still not yet.
Scared to go up there because last time he did, he got down aired for his troubles.
Yeah.
This time, though, just the up throw is finally going to be enough to seal it. Without limit, he's not going to live that one.
Yeah, he's going to need some... He's going to need to get Uroloki off the stage. He needs to get him off the stage and put himself in a position where he can edge guard, where he can use that poor recovery that Cloud has against Uroloki.
Uroloki is more than happy to just sit there and charge limit if Gibbous is not going to approach him. With this kind of a lead, he has no need to go in right now.
Yeah. He just needs to sit there, charge limit. He has to make Gibbous approach. Well, Gibbous is forced to approach in this situation. So Gibbous needs to find a way to get in and get this edge guard. 147%. Just one tilt will kill. Pretty soon that up throw will kill. Gibbous needs to be so careful.
But he's getting the juggles going right now. He did a...
Oh my gosh. You always have to be wary of that up air coming out so quick and being so, so deadly. Man.
It's a solid combo break when you're just going for these reads, right? You don't have the confirms. Gibbous probably trying to catch his landing with an up tilt, but it wasn't quick enough.
Mm.
Gibbous going for his tried and true.
And the gamer.
Counter pick the gamer. He also, I think he prefers Mewtwo in this matchup when he can get away with it. He really likes trying to do the Mewtwo Cloud.
Yeah, that forward air is so quick and so deadly as well. It's that really solid kill option that can connect a lot more often than a lot of Greninja's tools could.
As well as the fact that Mewtwo is super floaty, so he can go deep and not risk just dying. Greninja can't really fall with Cloud and force him into a scary option because Greninja falls way too fast, and if he's way down there, he's going to die.
But, oh my goodness, what
Mewtwo,
a combo from Gibbous.
Mewtwo can just push you to the edge and then float with you on your way down and say, I dare you to pick an option. I got this forward air waiting.
Yeah, definitely. And then wasn't able to take out the stock just there, but he showed so much crazy potential that I wasn't used to. Wow, the neutral air into the up smash. So smart and well placed from Gibbous, knowing that he could connect that. Wow, an unfortunate shield drop from Uroloki. First stock going to Gibbous. This looks looking so much better than that first game.
Looked like he was just trying to charge it, but he B-reversed the charge and threw it right at Uroloki, catching his out of shield option.
Oh, wow. He attempted to drag him down with the neutral air. Gibbous is definitely smelling the blood.
And he narrowly avoided that, the Klim hazard coming out of Uraloki coming down. He almost died right there to some shenanigans.
I just love the pressure that Gibbous has been applying this entire game. He's been so aggressive with his tilts, with his forward airs. He hasn't really allowed Uraloki to get much in there, making him think that he could land that blade beam, making him waste that limit, and then putting himself in yet another fantastic position. Gibbous's Mewtwo is looking so good right now.
Man, what's strange is percent-wise, Uraloki's not too far off from an even game, but if you're watching, you can definitely see the pressure is on. It feels like he has to do something, and Gibbous just seems so relaxed.
Ooh, a bit too relaxed, overextending, and he gets punished by the down air. Uraloki now in a much better position, a much better even position. Wow, what a smart recovery from Uraloki. You were talking about how Gibbous has been more than confident to drop down, and then he uses that wall jump that this stage gives him. Whoa, what? That would have been so bad if he had got bounced off the stage. Uraloki showing signs of life, getting a lot of damage after that first stock. If he gets another limit charge, it could be the stock for him yet again.
Right now, Mewtwo is a very light character. He's approaching kill percent if Uraloki's able to get. He went for the jab disable.
Oh, he got it. Oh, unable to get a fully charged, but will that kill? Yes, Gibbous taking now, game two with the Mewtwo.
Here's a question for you, Zan. If Gibbous just went for jab disable, and you know who Gibbous is as a player, you've played against him before. You know the way he is as a person. If he just went for jab disable and missed it, and then he jabs you again, what do you expect to come next?
I'm probably going to expect the disable.
So why did Uraloki just get hit? That is...
You know what really surprises me?
That's the Gibbous special. That's the I'm going to cheese you with something stupid, yeah. And if it doesn't work, I'm going to keep trying it until it works.
You know what's funny about that? He was able to do that exact same thing in the first game when Gibbous down-aired his shield twice, and on the second one, he gets up-aired for it. But he wasn't able to do it in that second game. Possibly the character switch confusing him a little bit. I don't know. Tournament jitters, whatever. No. This game three is now on Battlefield. Gibbous's Mewtwo is looking so solid right now, and I really feel like this is a great stage for both of these characters, neighbor. Tell me wrong.
Oh, no, that's definitely correct. Mewtwo loves this stage because he can cover the platforms.
Oh, my goodness. Not going to kill.
He was in the air. Had he landed, that would have killed.
Man.
I'm almost certain. I could be wrong, but I'm 100% positive about the fact that he was in the air, so that was a much weaker finishing
hit. Regardless, it sends a message.
It does. A better message would have been, I've killed you. But it certainly did send a message, yes. Uraloki was in control of that situation.
I definitely agree, but... Yes, this stage definitely helping out Uraloki a lot. He's utilizing these platforms. He's utilizing the fact that Gibbous has to try to recover around these platforms against them, and he's getting a lot of damage for it. Now has that limit again. I don't know if he's going to try to save it for the next stock or if he's going to burn it. Let's see.
I mean, he's got plenty of control right now, but I'd say if he has an opportunity to kill Gibbous and he doesn't take it, that's a mistake.
Oh, now he's going to be forced to use it to recover? Maybe no. Gibbous lets him get back on the stage, and then he wasted anyway.
Yeah, expecting Gibbous to run in potentially with a dash attack. He's gone with a number of those throughout the set. But this time, he just waited patiently for Uraloki to throw out the hitbox. That's punishable!
Jeez, that was a great attempt from Gibbous, but great patience from Uraloki. Not getting caught out of his shield again, and is going to be getting a stock for it. Now in the lead on the final game of Loser Semis.
Uraloki's been playing so patiently on these platforms, using them as an avenue to gain his limit. To force Gibbous in his general direction, and then, oh my goodness, is he getting the combos off?
Man, these platforms are so huge right now for Uraloki. He's been getting so much damage, keeping Gibbous in the air. Not going to get punished for it. He barely had time to perfect shield that. If Gibbous was able to throw that any sooner, that would have been it. Nothing, just waits at the ledge instead of going for some option to contest Uraloki. Uraloki is sitting so comfortably right now in his first stock while Gibbous is in those kill percents already for possibly an up air, any smash attack, the up smash. That trade was so crucial because guess what? Uraloki has another stock and he has another game to play in this tournament.
Jump air dodging there was so dangerous for Gibbous. Uraloki sitting in shield right there could have come out with any number of options. Jump up air might have been able to kill. The up smash trading definitely took that game for him. But when you jump air dodge in front of somebody who's sitting in shield, he is definitely ready to wait for whatever option's coming next. He knows you're coming down with the forward air because you're Mewtwo. That's what you do.
Yeah.
And he took that opportunity and ran with it.
Yeah, I said it was a good save for both of them, but that, yes, he had so much control. He was able to keep Gibbous in the air for so long. Gibbous was unable to get back down to the stage in those crucial moments where he needed it, and Euroloki was just able to have a ball with his fantastic aerials and juggle game that he just dominated with.